Hello dear students, welcome back to your English class of CB, the course book. So in the last class we saw that, you know, the chapter The Treasure Within, we saw the part one, that how Hafiz the contractor, in one of his interview, when you know he was having this conversation with Miss Bella, he shared all his childhood experience, his school days and all his memories. And we were about to see, like in the second part, that today how Hafiz has reached up to this position. So let us have a quick small recap of the previous class that we had. We saw that, you know, like he was not at all interested in his studies. He was just a kind of a sports freak who was only interested in playing and nothing else. In fact, he was also the leader of a gang. He would have gang fights and plan strategies, and these were the things which interested him more rather than books. And one day it so happened that we saw in the last class that, you know, in order to distract the others, what did he do is that he continued playing the complete hour. You know, he just thought of distracting everybody and he played the game of what? Chor police, right? But however, we saw that just his principal's advice had really a great effect on him. As it was just because of his principal advice that in his, like, you know, higher secondary, in his SSC, he secured 50% result. A student who was not at all interested in his studies secured no less than 50% result just because of the advice of his principal. Okay, so today let us see the second part of the same chapter. Okay, all right, let's start then. It so happened that, you know, like this Hafiz, he wanted to join the army and his aunt wouldn't allow it. Okay, and along with his aunt, even his mother won't allow him to join the police force either. She asked him to do his graduation, and using some influences, like somehow he got admission into this Jai Hind College, and there he had to study French. But he was very weak at French. So as a result, he had to take his married cousin's help. Okay, he had a cousin who was already married, so he had to take her help, and her husband was an architect. And so, like, Hafiz started going to an architect's office just to learn French. And in this architect's office, in the architect's office, he saw that, you know, somebody drawing a window detail. Okay, you know, right, what does an architect do? Making the picture, the illustration, the image of the buildings, the houses and all. So as Hafiz was into his office, into his cousin's husband's office, so he saw, like, somebody was just drawing a window detail, and this window detail was a kind of a very advanced drawing. Okay, so then Hafiz told that person that you are drawing wrong, this is not the correct way to draw. In fact, Hafiz also added that the window he had drawn, that particular person was drawing, the window that he had drawn would not open. And as a result, the person who was working in that office, like, he didn't like that. And so there was a bet, you know, with the contractor. The person said, okay, like, fine, okay, if mine is wrong, if I'm drawing a wrong window and it won't open, chalo, I bet you, come on, you draw and show me. All right, so there was a bet between the two, and as a result, the contractor won. The contractor, that is Hafiz, about whom we are reading now, he's a contractor now, but I'm talking about those days when he was not a contractor. Okay, so he won the bet, and this surprised his cousin's husband. His cousin's husband was surprised to see that how come he drew such a beautiful, you know, picture, an image, an illustration image. So therefore, like, his cousin's husband asked him to draw a few specific things, some more things. Okay, and the moment, like, he was asked to do so, Hafiz did that at once, after which The man was so impressed that he asked Hafiz to drop everything and join architecture. Now, as a result, he got admission into the architecture, and that architect took him to the principal of the college just because of his drawing, because of his ideas. Okay, and in the college of architecture, nobody who had got below 80 to 90% was allowed to enter. But whereas we know how much Hafiz secured, remember he secured only 50%. So therefore, the principal warned him that okay, I will allow you to take part in the entrance examination, but if you do not do well, I will not allow you to join. So there was a criteria to get enrolled into that architect college. There will be entrance. Okay, so if he can secure the minimum percentage that is being required, then he would be allowed to join, or else no way out. So in the entrance examination, Hafiz, he secured A+ in the entrance examination, and that's all. After that, it was just a cakewalk for him. It was, cakewalk, a smooth way without any obstacle. And he stood first after that in the class, and first throughout ever after. Once he joined into that college, and throughout after that, he was first forever. In fact, Hafiz never made a plan. Once it so happened that one of his teachers, Mrs. Gupta, had told him, "You are useless in everything, but your sketches are so good." She had advised him to be an architect as he grew up, after growing up. And when he became an architect, he went back to meet the same teacher, Mrs. Gupta, and told her that, "Yes, what you did, I did, what you told me, I did so." Okay, so even Hafiz, during his young days, he never knew this was, the talent, the inbuilt talent which he had within himself. You remember the last class I gave you an assignment and homework that to discover your talent, your aptitude, your interest, your strength, right? I hope by now you have already found it out. Because once if you can know that, you can, climbing up, it'll be very easy for you to get the ladder towards success. So So as I told you, Hafiz was bad at language, his maths was also very bad. In fact, he never applied his mind to the studies at all. And when he was in a boarding school, where every day was a new day for him, there were tests and all, what he used to do, he just copied. That was the only thing that he would do. And those who always stood first or second in his school today are doing ordinary jobs. As for himself, the school life made him street smart. I repeat, the school life made him street smart. He learned more by what he did than what the books taught him. Okay? And at school, Hafiz was interested in other things, not in books. If it rained outside the class, he would think of the flowing water. He would forget the lecture and think about the flow of water with the dam. He would wonder how much water would the dam hold. Even though discipline in his school was very important, sometimes when a student would lose a button while fighting, in that case, that particular student would run to Hafiz, and Hafiz would cut a button from a chalk using a blade. So look at his mind. Suppose two students are fighting, and in that fight, one of the students lost one of the button of the shirt, and that particular student will run to Hafiz because they knew Hafiz would have some way or the other, solution for these problems. And what he would do? He would cut a button out of a chalk using a blade, and which no one could then see that his real button was missing. He would pass dinner with a full neat uniform. And today, when a client comes to Hafiz, he looks at him closely. He would observe his face cloths and manners, and that gives him an idea of his taste. So look at Hafiz's way of, you know, learning at the things. Today, he, as he's a contractor, if any client, any person approaches him with any kind of a business discussion, the very first thing that Hafiz does is that he would observe that person's face, clothes and manners. And as a result, that gives Hafiz an idea of his taste, and he is able to relate to people in a way that would be comfortable. And then he makes a sketch spontaneously. He gives it to his people in the office, and that is how he manages his works. In fact, the contractor, that is Hafiz, he says that his sketches are his mathematics, as because in his sketches what he has to do is that he puts design, he puts construction, psychology, that is the thoughts of the person who has approached him, his client, psychology, at the same time sociology, all these things together. So he says that his sketches are his mathematics. Making a sketch from all that is contractor's Hafiz's definition of mathematics. So with this, my dear students, we come to the end of part 2, which means the end of this chapter. I hope you understood, right, that each one of us, we have a treasure within us. You just need to dig that, find it out, and excel in that. That's all. Take care. And in case, if you have any doubt, you can get back to me. Okay? Thank you.